Hello everyone, welcome back. So today our topic of discussion will be an extended form of the last lecture. In the last lecture we have discussed something about, that means we had started something about the ozone. We had also started a major effect, that means ozone depleting substances, also seen something about ozone depleting potential. I've told you something about to look forward for the concept of what do you mean by ozone depleting substances, and we had discussed the ozone depleting substances and today we are going to start on the idea of how these ozone depleting substances are reacting. So last time I told you to do a work, and the work was you have to find out what the ozone depleting substances have potentials. That means what is the potential of CFCs, what is the potential of HFCs, etc., etc. Today we are going to extend this point and come on effect and reaction process. So we'll go with the reaction first and then we'll go with the effect. So majorly you people are having an idea about the effects. You are having a very, not at least complete idea, but a brief idea about what are the effects of ozones and what are the effects of ozone depleting substances. So it is very much clear to you people, but we should first look for the reaction. Reason is because unless and until we cannot understand, would not understand the area of reaction of ozone with the components such as chlorine, bromine or nitrous or sulfuric acidic compounds, we would rather it becomes impossible for us to understand how these products or how the ozone is causing a problem on human existence or non-human existence. Reason is because we know that ozone is protecting us. Depletion is causing a problem. This is also known to us. But how? Reason is because substances which are creating a problem in creation and regeneration of ozone is a major issue to be studied in the coming generations. So look forward for the very first process of how ozone is getting depleted. And the very popular term which you people know and you have an idea about this popular term, because we have been discussing this term since very past. And this is a general term which you people also know from the very start. It is not new to you. And PFCs, in the very first statement when we made it in the segment, we said that PFCs is something related to ozone. Why? Because it plays a major role. Tension, that means it is having a major role in depleting the layer ozone, and this ozone layer is very much having an effect because of chlorine. Reasons, because chlorine is a popular component used in popular products. So sprays, you go for sprays, you go for foams, you go for anything which you use daily, for example refrigerant, coolant products, ACs, etc., etc., and you'll find that chlorine is there somewhere. Not as a major part, but at least for a minor part also you can find chlorine in many products. And we'll see how this chlorine products acts on our ozone and it depletes. Okay, so we know that UV radiations are coming continuously, and without a breakage of UV radiation, it is converting O3 into, similarly it is also helping in the formation of O3 molecule, because when O2 and O radical, free radical, combines with the help of heat energy, it goes into a process of reaction and forms an O3 molecule. That is a very known form idea to you people. Now what happens with when CFC enters into the area of O3? What happens, the UV radiation, it breaks down the chlorine. So CFC is taken up as it is. So if you look forward for the structure of CFC, you find there is a 3 chlorine molecule and 1 fluorine molecule is present. Okay, in the diagram or a figure, you can see present in the upper part of the collar, and you can find the structure over here. So there's the carbon is combined with 3 chlorine molecule and 1 fluorine molecule. So that is structure of CFCs. Now what happens when the sun rays, it gets connected, or when the sun rays are coming, it gets reacted with the CFCs products. And what happens, this CFCs products, because it is of course a chemical, so the gaseous material or any chemical, it comes in contact with the component which is having the energy in it. Of course either it will dissociate or it will form. Now what happens with CFC is it starts dissociating. That means it starts breaking down. Similar happens with O3. We have seen in the last lectures also. We have to study how CFCs gets converted and how it reacts. CFCs ke saath mein kya hota hai? UV radiation ke heat energy ke karan chlorine molecule release out hona shuru ho jata hai. So it takes a process. Ek single molecule ke saath mein hum study karenge, so it becomes easy for you people. So consider that one chlorine molecule is eliminating out from the CFCs product. And now what is happening? This free chlorine radical, if it is breaking down from its original component, that is chlorofluorocarbon, it has to get attached to something because it cannot stay a free radical for more time, right? Because in the lecture also we have seen when it's O free radical, it spontaneously gets attached to some of the oxygen products. Maybe it is an O2 or maybe it is a single O. Anything can be possible. Similar goes with chlorine over here. Now chlorine is a free radical. It has to get combined to something. And what is around the chlorine or the free radical of chlorine is nothing else but ozone. Happens because this is a gaseous product which is almost to a level. We can level of ozone. It easily gets connected to that the ozone is O3. Now what happens when it gets connected to the O3? Because there is an exchange. Now you have to go back, rewind up yourself and just try to understand how these are converted. So you can remember your past lectures of chemistry. In the chemistry we have seen that there is sharing of electrons. So if you remember the sharing of electrons, protons, neutrons, logo ko pata hai chale. Sharing hone ke baad mein hi there is a formation and breaking of bonds. Similar happens over here. Jab chlorine atom radical एक स्ट्रेटोस्फीयर में होता है, यूवी रेडिएशन की वजह से वो क्या होना शुरू होता है, अटैच होना शुरू होता है सी O3 मॉलिक्यूल पे. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, O3 मॉलिक्यूल पे अटैच होते ही दैट मींस देयर इज अ शेयरिंग ऑफ बॉन्ड, एंड बिकॉज देयर इज अ शेयरिंग ऑफ बॉन्ड द O3 मॉलिक्यूल इज ऑक्यूपाइड, इट इज कंप्लीटेड, एंड व्हाट हैपेंस, इट फॉर्म्स अ न्यू प्रोडक्ट, एंड दिस न्यू प्रोडक्ट थिंग इज बट अ क्लोरीन नो ऑक्साइड, दैट इज ClO. सो देयर डिटैच कर लेता है क्लोरीन की तरफ, खींच लेता है एक ऑक्सीजन मॉलिक्यूल O3 में से और दो अलग क्लोरीन मोनोऑक्साइड दैट इज ClO और दूसरा प्रोडक्ट होता है आपका दैट इज O2. सो दैट इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप ऑफ CFCs फॉर्मेशन. नाउ नेक्स्ट हैपेंस, जब ये हुआ है तो ओके फाइन दैट इज ओके, O2 फिश रहा है ओके चलेगा. बट नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, दिस क्लोरीन मोनोऑक्साइड अगेन इज अटैक्ड बाय एन ऑक्सीजन एटम. And because again there is free radical, it means हमने पहले slide में देखा था O2 with the help of UV radiation is breaking down into 2O free radical. So अब ये O radical कहीं पे free होता है और जहाँ पे उसे कोई और protoxid या share करने वाला मिल जाता है वहाँ पे attach होना शुरू हो जाता है. और अब हो रहा है यहाँ पे free radical accept करने के लिए कौन मिल रहा है, तो it is ClO, that means chlorine monoxide. Now what happens is free radical of oxygen is again combined to that of oxygen radical of monoxide, chlorine monoxide, and it forms oxygen atom. Okay, that means O2 फिर से form हो जाता है. But जब O2 form हो रहा है, can you imagine जो combined था already chlorofluorocarbons के साथ में, अभी वो free हो गया है. That means chlorine freely सब जगह घूमने और किसी पे attack करने की कोशिश करेगा. And the same thing happens over here. Chlorine, because it is completely free, it is not having anything attached to itself, goes and it again attacks on the O3. Because it is the role of chlorine. वो कोई गलत कर रहा है. This part of action of any reaction, that is chemical reaction. So exchange होना ही चाहिए. Means protons, electrons, ये नहीं होगा तो एटम खत्म हो जाएगा, मॉलिक्यूल खत्म हो जाएगा, रेडिकल खत्म हो जाएगा. सेम थिंग इज डन बाय द क्लोरीन एटम, बिकॉज इट इज फ्री इट इज गोइंग एंड अटैकिंग अगेन बैक ऑन द O3 मॉलिक्यूल एंड सेम प्रोसेस टेक्स प्लेस अगेन एंड अगेन. फिर O3 में से O सिंगल किया जाता है, रिलीज आउट किया जाता है, फिर कोई O फ्री रेडिकल होगा, ऑक्सीजन रेडिकल, वो क्लोरीन O पे अटैक करेगा एंड देन इट विल अगेन फॉर्म O2 मॉलिक्यूल. बट कैन यू इमेजिन इससे क्या हो रहा है, द न्यू फॉर्मेशन ऑफ O2. This O2 cannot be utilized by living organism. Something more should be kept in mind. Because it is at the stratospheric level. We can go in the stratosphere. Right? So it is dwelling over there. It is not come down also. But also, there is a complete destruction. Breakdown of O3 molecule. Bar O3 molecule break ho rahe hai. O2 form ho rahe hai. Break ho rahe hai. O2 form, and this process goes on continuously for reason because chlorine has the capability to continuously react with the O3. It continuously can break down the O3 and destroy O3 into O2, and this O2 is not utilized by living organism also. So there's a problem with chlorine. Henceforth, said in the last lecture that almost the CFCs have the capability to destroy in a day 10,000 molecules of oxygen. You can just imagine if it can have a single day, that is also not a calculated day. It can vary from area to area because it changes from region to region and temperature and season to season. So if it is there somewhere in a part in industrial areas, it is more. So because it is more in some kind of industrial area, developing areas where the automobiles, where the radiations or the used coolants are, there's more and more emission. What happens? Oxygen form hota rahega, but wo stress mein rahega, niche nahi aayega. And will be not utilized by living organisms also. On other hand, oxygen bar bar khatam hota rahega because of the reaction of chlorine. So that is the problem of ozone depleting substances, that is CFCs. The second ozone depleting substances, which we have seen in the very last lecture, it was something related to volcanic eruption, if you remember. So volcanic eruption mein se jo bhi products niklenge ya fir jo bhi natural calamities se niklega, okay, not only volcanic eruption but also थंडर लाइटनिंग प्रोसेस, ये हमने एसिड रेन की प्रोसेस में भी देखा था. सो दीज बेसिकली टू नेचुरल प्रोसेसेस आर कॉजिंग द एसिडिक मटेरियल टू बी गेट रिलीज्ड इनटू द नेचुरल एनवायरनमेंट और नेचुरल ऑक्सीजनेटेड एनवायरनमेंट एंड इट इज कॉजिंग समवट अ डिस्ट्रक्टिव प्रोडक्ट लाइक नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड. सो नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड दैट्स NOx, इट कैन बी फॉर्म दैट इज N2O, NO2 और N2O2. वी हैव सीन इन द लास्ट लेक्चर व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन दीज प्रोडक्ट्स गो एट अ हाई लेवल, बिकॉज वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन द part of acid rain, that these products can react in both the form, wet form and dry form. So if they settle down on the earth, they react with the moisture of the earth level. But if they go at a higher peak level, what they do, they directly do not react with the, especially when they are going at the stratosphere level, they instead of reacting with the moisture current, they go and react with the ozone component. So what they do, instead of move on and going in reaction with the water molecule, that is H2, they go and find a moisture component with the help of O3 molecule, that is ozone. So what happens, this O3 is, because it's a continuous process, so this O3, because of the help of UV radiation, is breaking down into a useful component, and it's a rigorous process, that is O2 and O. Now what happens when nitrous oxide enters? This nitrous oxide reacts with O3 molecule and it is forming a harmful product, is nitrogen dioxide, that's N2, and free molecule of oxygen is released out. Similarly, again this nitrogen dioxide will react with the free radical oxygen. Okay, it will not stop. It will react with the free radical of oxygen and it will form more dangerous product, that is called as NO. So it is much more dangerous. So this reaction is continuously going on. So you can imagine that single oxygen to save our own. That is one more reason. Also, sometimes these nitrous oxides, okay. So I'm saying in a brief, like nitrous oxides, reason is because we have seen that nitrogen or nitrous products can occur in any form. They can immediately react at any stages. So this can sometimes combine chlorine monoxides also to form chlorine nitrate. And this is a product which is much harmful for the ozone because it is having a direct effect on nitrogen. So when chlorine is harmful and nitrogen is harmful, it is causing effect on ozone to deteriorate. Now think about when both are come together and they are creating effect on the ozone, what would be the problem? It is a depletion. So I'll give you a picture in which we can find that the studies have shown around in 1979. So you can see where the area, that is the somewhat smaller incise, that is this purplish color area. Okay, so that is basically something written of ozone. So it was, that means ozone hole create hona shuru ho gaya tha non-south pole pe. But this has been extended in 2008, approximately, if I'm not wrong, to such a huge area. So similar area, but the atmosphere has changed. The ozone has depleted very much, and the hole is created on the poles. So when the holes are created on the poles, it is very drastic, as we have seen earlier also. Let's move on to what's the effect of the ozone then? So we are known very well with the idea that ozone deplete ho raha hai Antarctic regions pe, zyada deplete kar raha hai Antarctic and Arctic regions pe. If you go with Antarctic, so if you go with Arctic regions, it is hotter. Temperature getting much more hotter than the expected. So बहुत ज़्यादा गर्मी बढ़ रही है, बहुत जितनी ज़्यादा गर्मी बढ़ेगी ग्लोबल वार्मिंग होगा. ओके, सो ग्लोबल वार्मिंग एक जगह पर तो इफेक्ट दूसरी जगह पर देखना शुरू हो जाता है. सो इज मेल्टिंग डाउन ऑफ आइस. टेम्परेचर बढ़ा है, रिसाइकल्स चेंज हुई है, दैट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. सिमिलरली इन द एंटार्क्टिक जोन बिकॉज द रेडिएशन आर डायरेक्ट कमिंग टू द अर्थ, प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए ओजोन नहीं है, रेडिएशन को रिफ्लेक्ट बैक करने के लिए ओजोन नहीं है, खत्म हो रहा है ओजोन. रेडिएशन जो हार्म है वो डायरेक्टली एंटर कहां पे एंटार्क्टिक में, बिकॉज द रेडिएशन आर वेरी हाई इन कैपेसिटी, इट इज एंटरिंग द अर्थ सर्फेस एंड दिस इज रिएक्टिंग विथ योर आइस एंड ऑफ कोर्स इट इज मेल्ट डाउन ऑफ द आइस. सी लेवल बढ़ रहा है, उस वजह से लेवल ऑफ सी बढ़ रहा है, आइसबर्ग्स मेल्ट डाउन हो रहे हैं, ऑर्गेनिज्म वहां पे खत्म हो रहे हैं, स्पेशली द ऑर्गेनिजम्स और द लिविंग बॉडीज सच एज शार्क्स, व्हेल और पेंगुइन्स व्हिच आर टिपिकली फाउंड इन द एरियाज ऑफ एंटार्क्टिक रीजंस आर गेटिंग बैश्ड. सो नंबर ऑफ पॉपुलेशंस ऑफ दिस ऑर्गेनिज्म गेटिंग रिड्यूस्ड. उसका सेकंड इफेक्ट अभी हो रहा है दैट द सी लेवल इज रेजिंग इटसेल्फ, दैट मींस द वेव्स आर रेजिंग इटसेल्फ, लेवल ऑफ वाटर रेज इन द सी एंड दिस वाटर हैज टू गेट एडजस्टेड समवेयर. When it has to be adjusted somewhere, it is moving rigorously to the part which is away. So these are getting or passing on the water from one area to another area, and what we can find out is a resultant of tsunami. So that is one more reason for having problems in the localized area also. So we feel like how come tsunami come in the area of the coastal regions. So that is more reason because Antarctic melting down, icebergs are melting down, and we are not protecting the iceberg because of the level of the water is rise, and it is trying to adjust itself. The water is trying to adjust itself. It is having the space area very less, and now when it has to try to adjust itself, the water body moves. That means the water level is moving and it is coming into the area of the land area, like coastal area especially, and resultant is nothing else but the Antarctic cycle and tsunamis. So that is one natural effect. The second effect is being caused on the humans, or rather I would say it is caused on the organisms, living organisms. Let's talk about humans. So it is pretty much a common idea which we know that if a direct effect or a direct sun radiation, UV radiation come and hit a human body, or we human come in daily contact with UV radiation, the problem is that we can suffer from the infections, or we can suffer from the major diseases like cancers, especially skin cancer. Many people have the problem of skin burns, right? And we find that this problem takes place maximally during the summer season. Why have we thought about it? And we feel like applying somewhat body lotions or sunscreens protect us. That one more reason being explained always that put on the UV radiation claimed lotions during the summer season is because they are protecting from your UV radiation. But can you think about they are protecting partially? Its effect is reduced. Again, you are in contact with the sun, and again there will be some part of your body which is getting reacted with the direct radiation of sun, and this causing a sun. So many people have the problem of sunburn, that is they have red patches, or maybe the skin dark, that is melanin component increases in during summer season. So that is the reason because of UV radiation. We have problem of skin, that is a new kind of evolution found in the human generation because we were having but not that good amount of skin cancers. So reason is because we are having a direct effect of UV radiation on us. Reason is the penetration on India is of equator part. So we people are almost on equator side. We are on equator part, that means we have to suffer more radiation, more heat, and that's the reason we are more attracted to kind of diseases. The important which one right now the study has shown something related to cataracts or blinding. So cataract bindu. That path is being now discovered. So if a person directly has an effect of due to the radiation, it can cause an eye problems also. Hence is one more reason that we usually apply glares to our eyes during the summer seasons. So that is a human effect. Of course there is an effect also on the seas and rivers and water bodies, rather I would say. So it's not only the melting down increase in the water level, but it is having an effect on the organisms which are living in the water. So that is called as flora and fauna. It is having direct effect also on flora and fauna. Many species are there which have ended up because of this radiation. Reason is because the food production, the phytoplanktons which produces the food, the food chain is completely destroyed. Food chain itna zyada disturb hota hai, jiski wajah se fish, shrimps, crabs, jo pure animals kisi plant pe water plant depend hota hai, वो कम्प्लीटली खत्म होना शुरू हो जाता है. रीजन है कि बिकॉज नाइट्रोजन नहीं मिल पाता है, नाइट्रोजन रिटेंशन खत्म हो जाता है. अभी हमने देखा था नाइट्रोजन इज डायरेक्टली रिएक्टिंग, सो नाइट्रोजन अगर नहीं पाएगा, रिटेन नहीं हो पाएगा, तो आपको कहाँ से मिलेगा फ्रूटफुल प्रोडक्ट, कहाँ से मिलेगा, नहीं मिल पाएगा. सो दैट इज वन ऑफ द इफेक्ट. कंट्रोल ऑफकोर्स यू कैन, So theories are there which tell how to use a chlorofluorocarbon, how to use hydrofluorocarbon. Many have given up the idea of using up. Many countries have given up the idea. Rather, we can say many countries have also given up the supplementaries. That means they have replaced the products of chlorofluorocarbons and hydrofluorocarbons so that which will cause less effect. So have created. So you can use these products. So you have find out which are the products which can be a replaceable material for FCs and HFCs. We had discussed this in the part of segment. Similarly, many theories have been given, which of course the theory is somewhat much not realistic actually, but they are given. And many countries are trying to do this rigorously. But of course, of the economy problem or because of money requirement, it requires a lot of money. This project are going into a darker side. The projects are that some consider that if you create a kind of spray which can fill the hole, means they are saying that you have to do a cooling sprays or you have to create the ozone spray specially, and you have to carry these sprays with the help of the aeroplanes, with the help of the jets, and you have to directly fit into the ozone area. Anyway, because jets can fly in the stratosphere level, so we see this also. So if go and spray this directly, and maybe the ozone can get repaired. So it's like sewing up a cloth. So it's rather not possible. Rather, on the other hand, it can be possible if you try to lessen the use of the transport, because transportation is giving out hazardous products, sulfur products, nitrogen products. So you can use less amount of transportation products, less amount of cooling products. Okay, I'm not saying you completely should ban these products, but at least you can control the use of these products. You can plant more trees. You try to plant number of trees which have a good habit, have a good capability of capturing the oxygen. I'm saying it that plant shrubs, herbs, it's okay, but at least also try to plant the trees which can grow with a good and faster rate. Reason is because if they grow faster, they are huge size, they capture much the poisonous material, get pure kind of oxygen. So of course, if someone is having a farm area, try to use more natural products rather than using insecticides or pesticides. Go for use more nano products, manures which are natural. You go for the cow dung, degradation or components of cow dung you can use. For that case, many natural and organic products are available for us in the city as right now also. So try to use less amount of pesticides because they are having chlorine, bromine containing components in major area. So because they effective, they help to give a good growth, they at the same time cause an ozone depletion. One thing which you have to keep in mind regards to this complete chapter is the day of ozone, that means World Ozone Day, because this was the question was asked and it is 16th of September. Also, I have given you some of the questions which you can note down and study on these questions. If you study even these questions, you will